Hey, this is Sebastian from the Metal Gods Meltdown, and today I'm joined by
Thomas from Wolfheart.
I love your soon-to-be-released fifth album, which gets released on the 10th of April. Are you feeling confident about its release with everything that's going on with this damn COVID-19 virus?
I'm feeling very confident about the album, about the music and the production and the release. Everything else is a little bit more blurry because, yeah, there's no tours now to support the release. The whole release date of the album was decided based on the North American tour. And a lot of the album promo was based on the publicity of the tour. So a lot of question marks how things are actually going to go. But still, I'm very confident about the album itself. So it's more like a challenge now with the promotion.
Has the label thought about putting it back sometime into June or something like that? I don't know.
We did have that discussion, but all the albums were already shipped to the distributors. We already had the two videos out at that point. So I think it would have been more complicated to actually move it now when everything is already in motion. And who knows? Nobody knows what's going to be the situation in the summer. It might be even worse. It's impossible to predict what would be the better time than now. And at least now we have a little bit more attention from the label because they did move a lot of other releases into the summer and next fall. Yeah, cool. Who knows? This might be the best time for a long time.
You never know. Yeah. With your isolation and everything, have you as a band thought about doing webcasts, even doing a whole stream of the new album?
We've been thinking about a lot of different options. Right now, the label managed to arrange a lot of interviews, and I was supposed to do a lot of interviews during the tour. So now everything is happening in Skype or email. Until the album comes out, we're going to be fully booked with that side of promotion. But of course, now there is nothing happening after the release. The whole calendar is empty, so we definitely going to come up with a lot of different ideas to use social media to be able to keep the connection with the fans, because it's a bad thing for any album to just band to go quiet and not to do anything. So we just need to get very creative.
What has the general feedback been like so far from media and fans to the two songs you have released?
It's been really, really good. I wasn't really worried about the first single as a song or like the quality of the song. It was label and management who insisted to have that as a first single, and that I would have never chosen that song myself. But I gave them the permission to choose the first single, and I get to choose the second one. So luckily, the feedback was really good. It was it's the last song of the album, and it was written to be the last song of the album, not to be the presentation of the album. So that was a little bit like, I was a little bit more concerned than I usually would have been ever to when it comes to getting new music out. But it was really well taken from the fans, and the first reviews so far that we have seen from the album have been insanely good. So, and like I said, I'm very confident about the album. Everything else is just this weird vortex of chaos that's taking the whole world. Yeah. Not down necessarily, but things are looking very, very. I mean, the movie, but I don't know. Is the movie? I don't know if the movie's been directed by Stephen King or Steven Spielberg.
That's what it feels like, man, doesn't it? Absolutely, and it is. It's a nightmare. It is.
Yeah, it is a nightmare. I'm just hoping it is Spielberg doing the direction of this movie, because then it has a kind of like a heroic good ending. But if it's Stephen King, we're going to be fucked. There's going to be a very unhappy ending, but it feels very unreal. This is going to change the world, I believe. Like, there's going to be a lot of things that people are going to refer before or after the virus. It's going to change a lot of things, I believe.
Video for Hail of Steel, that looks really hot. Did you get burned when you were filming that?
Almost. I was okay, but the first thing we did with the shooting was the drummer, and then we had the fire pillars a little bit too close, the drummer, and it was very windy, so he was only able to play like 15 seconds and then run away and then come back to 15 seconds because, it was really hard. That's what I like about using actual real fire in the shootings instead of these backstage pyros that you control with the you have a programming and you use the gas and everything, but it looks too industrial. It's a lot easier to control, but it looks too symmetrical, too industrial. Real fire moves with the wind and goes where it kind of wants to go. So it looks cooler, but it's a little bit more challenging to work with also.
So was that you guys practicing social distancing with that then, was it?
Well, now looking back, the making of the video, that makes a lot of sense what is going on in the world. So for everybody, best way to be safe from the virus is just make a ring of fire around you and stay inside.
We'll be right back. Which song is your favorite on the album today and why?
The song called Reaper from the album. And I think because the lyrics and especially the chorus of the song really underlines the whole theme of the album and about the winter war between Finland and Russia and the Second World War and how outnumbered the Finnish army was and still was able to, against all the odds, to stop the Russian army to invade Finland.
How pleased are you with your record company, Napalm Records, with their involvement with the release? Because they're doing quite a lot of different packages, aren't they?
This is the second album released by Napalm, and I'm so far really happy about the work. It's getting better and better, the cooperation with them. Nothing was bad on the previous album, but of course, new label, new people. It takes a little bit of time to know how different people work together and how things work in the label. But it's been really good, especially these times when things are getting fucked up. There's a lot of support from the label. They've been very flexible. They've been also working really hard to do extra promotion and finding new angles with the promotion now that there is no tours happening. So it's been really good, and I think this whole virus thing really underlined how good label that is for us, because they are also in a bad situation and still they are devoting a lot of time for our release and being constantly available and also checking out constantly how things are with the band during the situation. So it's a good label for us, definitely.
When all of these restrictions eventually cease, would he be having a release party and then hopefully getting out on this tour?
We have a European headlining tour booked already for September, October. So I do hope that everything is cleared by then, so we could jump directly back to the touring cycle. The North American tour was moved to February and March 2021. And we have a Finnish tour being booked for November and December. So if things clear during the summer, we get to jump right back to the touring cycle. I just hope that actually happens, because we have a lot of things waiting in the future now, even though now everything is completely cancelled and wiped out. It's just half a year of waiting, and hopefully things that have been planned starting from September will actually happen. So, but who knows? Yes. Who knows? Again, Stephen King or Steven Spielberg. We'll see how everything ends up.
Your voice is really phenomenal. So before a show, do you not speak for a few hours or have a big slug of bourbon?
The only key thing that I do need to do during the tour is sleep enough and drink enough water. And one thing is really a killer for my voice, and I've been talking with a lot of the guys doing growling, and you shouldn't talk much after the show inside the venue. The worst thing for the throat is trying to compete with the DJ or other band. So shouting with the fans after the show when there's another band playing, that is a horrible mistake. But otherwise, it's just I don't do any warm-ups, or I don't need to I usually have one or two interviews always before the show. So it's very primitive and simple instrument that luckily seems to, so far at least, work really easily. But a lot of damage can be done after the show.
When did you first realize you wanted to be a musician, specifically a vocalist?
It's easier to say pinpoint that when I knew that I want to play guitar, and when I knew that I'm going to be a songwriter instead of a musician. The guitar player thing happened when I was 6, and I got a cassette of a Mötley Crüe, Dr. Feelgood, and I was playing the Kickstart My Heart on a tennis racket until my parents got really annoyed and bought me a guitar. And then I started to play guitar, and I went to have a guitar lessons for 2 months, but I got so bored of learning other people's stuff that they had this event after 2 months of guitar lessons in the school that you needed to play a part of the song you learned. And I thought it's really stupid to learn anybody else's songs. Why don't I just come up with something of my own? Probably was a really shitty song because I didn't really know how to play guitar yet. From that point on, I just constantly came up with my own ideas never really stopped to play, learn anybody else's songs, like or solos or anything. So I think already at that age, I was a lot more focused on actually, I wouldn't say writing because I didn't know anything about writing music, but just focusing on creating stuff on my own instead of just trying to become the best musician I could. The vocals, in the small village where I was born, there was only one death metal band, and the vocalist of the band happened to live in my neighborhood. And so I got the first demo of the band when I was really young. I think I was like 11 or 12. In the early 90s, I never heard growling vocals. I didn't know what death metal is until I got that two-song demo. And that was growling vocals, and I was hooked instantly. And that, though, of course, me being a young kid in the village, they were like the teenagers, and naturally they were the coolest guys ever, being in the band, in the village. I kind of like got this idolizing of a death metal band thing going on really early. So I guess that kind of like decided that I'm going to do a growling vocals myself.
Can you remember your first ever gig with Wolfheart and how it felt to have a crowd watching you?
Wolfheart gig, yes. It was 2013. It was one indoor festival in Helsinki, the capital of Finland. I had played about 700 to 800 gigs before that, so in as a gig itself, it wasn't that special. Naturally, it was the first gig for the band, so it was of course very exciting, and being also very nervous for presenting a new band for the audience. But it was a really cool event. It was a really cool venue, so we got to start the gigs of the band in a very good the circumstances. So it wasn't a small venue where we just starting to play gigs for a small crowd. It was a big venue, big crowd. So it was a really good start for the band.
Your biggest accomplishment so far with Wolfheart?
I would say the whole North American thing, not just for Wolfheart, because I had a lot of previous bands. I already released 20 albums. I never got to play in North America. That kind of like became like a big thing that I was really expecting to get it done, but it never happened with any of my previous bands until the previous album of Wolfheart, Constellation of the Black Light. Then I got to play in North America, and we did two tours there already, and then we got to also do a tour in South America. So it kind of like a Wolfheart opened like two completely new continents for me, which is quite a big thing, because I did a lot of tours in Europe and naturally in Scandinavia and Russia. I've done Asia a few times with my different bands. Never got to play in South or North America. So it was that's a really big thing for me as a musician, to be able to open those doors.
Going back to the album, what made you choose the subject of the Finnish-Russian war? It's not like a subject so widely known, I guess, in the UK.
It doesn't play a big part in the whole war history in that sense. It didn't really mean anything for the Second World War or the outcome of the war, but it was a huge thing for Finnish people. I think it's more like a Finnish thing than anything else, because it kind of like ensured our independence. The biggest thing is like the whole mentality and will of power and endurance of the perseverance of the Finnish army being so badly outnumbered against this huge legendary war nation, Russia. They had just for the statistics, they had 3,000 tanks and Finland had 32. They had almost 4,000 planes and we had 114. Wow. And their manpower, they were having a war in different fronts. It was not just against Finland, it was the whole Second World War going on. But still they had the three times the manpower also. And still Finland was able to stop the invasion of the army. So that's quite a big thing in the Finnish history for Finnish people. So every year when there's Independence Day, that comes up very strongly. So it's very present still in the Finnish culture. So cool thing for a Finnish band to write about it. But I do understand it's not that well known outside Finland.
Can you give me four words to describe Wolfheart?
Winter, definitely one. That's a huge inspiration for me, also with the music. Wolf, in general, majestic animal, and also the the two sides, being the leader of the pack or being the lone wolf warrior. That also is connected with the Finnish war history and kind of on the whole wolf kind of mentality. I'm gonna say still, it also comes from the name of the band is Heart. That's the attitude I really look up to about the whole our grandfather's generation that was taking part of the Finland still being independent after the wars and rebuilding the country. So it's a certain attitude and will of power that I think is also very connected with the band and us being very hands-on when it comes to like running the band.
Festival or small intimate gig?
Small intimate gig.
Lordi or Amorphis?
Oh, Amorphis 10 times.
Sauna or beer?
Sauna.
Vinyl or digital?
Vinyl.
Last one is Lapland or lap dance?
Definitely Lapland.
Do you have any final words for your fans and our listeners?
Stay home for a while. We're going to see you soon when this whole world epidemic crisis chaotic situation blows over. Just hang on tight. Watch Netflix. Let's see at the tours, hopefully in September. This is Tuomas from Moonport, and you are listening to Metal God's Meltdown.